Hello guys, my name is Gautam and in this video I will be telling you guys about what is AJAX. So if you are a newcomer to AJAX, this video will be helpful to you. So let's get started. So first of all, AJAX stands for Asynchronous JavaScript and XML. So it is a technique by which we request data from a remote server without reloading the entire page. So it is a technique and it is not a programming language. I want to tell you guys about it. It is a misconception around the world that it is a programming language. It is not a programming language, rather it is a technique used by web developers around the world in order to make websites behave like desktop applications. So it is a technique, not a programming language. So what technologies comprise AJAX? So what technologies are involved in AJAX? So these are the programming languages, that is HTML, CSS, JavaScript, XML, JSON and PHP. Where HTML and CSS are used to at the client side, and JavaScript is used to make request, and XML, JSON are the request formats, and PHP is used at the server side. So these technologies are used in AJAX. So what is asynchronous in AJAX? So I will be telling you guys about what is asynchronous in AJAX. So asynchronous generally means that we are exchanging data from the server, or we are posting data to the server in the background without having to refresh the page again and again. So this is meant by asynchronous. So we are exchanging data in the background. So let me just show you the standard client server application that we use in day-to-day basis. That is, this is the client, this is the server, and we are making a request to server for some data and we are getting some response from the server. So these are the standard client server applications where client has to wait for the response from the server to execute other tasks on the web page. So these are just static applications, not a dynamic application. So we want AJAX to make our applications dynamic in nature. So let me show you a standard AJAX application. So same example, we have a client, and in this case we have numerous servers. That is, we are working on the same server but we will be making multiple requests at the same time. So let me show you. So as you can see in the animation, we have a client and we have three instances of the same server that we are making a request. So this is the very advantage of AJAX, of using AJAX, because we can make multiple requests at the same time. So this is request 1, request 2 and request 3. So multiple requests are happening concurrently in the same time, or client doesn't have to wait for a response from a server in order to make any request. So this is the major advantage of AJAX, by which we can exchange data from the server, or we can post data to the server without having to reload the page again and again. So what about the response in AJAX application? So we have made the request in the AJAX application. So what about the response? So responses from the server in AJAX are handled in the form of callbacks. So basically, a callback is a special kind of function which is used in AJAX so that server can respond to the client when it is ready to send data to the client. So server will say to the client that I am ready, so I am just executing this callback function. So callback is used in AJAX in that aspect. So enough talking, so let's learn how to implement AJAX into our application. So let's start. So step number one, we need to create an XML HTTP request object. So all modern browsers support the XML HTTP request object. So this is the backbone of AJAX. So the XML HTTP request object can be used to exchange data with the server behind the scenes. So this means that it is possible to update parts of a web page without reloading the whole web page. So the first step is to create an XML HTTP request object, and it is supported by all browsers. So what is the syntax for creating this object? Let me show you. So in this slide I will show you the syntax for creating XML HTTP request object. So as I told you earlier, that is, all modern browsers including Chrome, Firefox, Internet Explorer, Edge, Safari, Opera have a built-in XML HTTP request object. So here is the syntax for creating an XML HTTP request object. First of all, we create a variable and we initialize it to the XML HTTP request class. So generally we declare a variable in JavaScript by the var keyword. So var x HTTP is equal to new XML HTTP request. So x HTTP is the variable name. So this we can be declaring a simple variable of HTTP request object. Step number two. So we have to make a request to the server by using this x HTTP request object. So the XML HTTP request object is used to exchange data with a server. So in the previous slide we have made the object. So in this slide, in this step, we need to make a request to the server by using this object. So the implementation part I will show you. What is the implementation? First of all, just write xhttp.open. So open method is used to make a request. So here we are providing a get method and a URL and a true parameter which signifies that it is a asynchronous request. And to send a request to a server, we use the open and send methods of the XML HTTP request object, where get signifies the method name and this ajax.info.txt signifies the URL by which we are requesting data. And this true parameter signifies that this is a AJAX request. So if I set this parameter to false, then it will signify that I am not making a AJAX request and it will be just a static application. So you can see here the get is signifying the method used in the request. So it can be either be get or post. So if you are posting data to the server, so the method will be post. And this is the URL of the file that we want to load in our web page. And true signifies that we are making asynchronous request. If we set it to false, then it will not be a AJAX request. So this is the whole picture of how to make a request to the server for data. Either we can use get or post. So step number three. So in this step, we will handle the response that is coming from the server. We have made the request. So now we have to handle the response that is coming from the server. So there is a property of the request that we have made, the XML HTTP request. The property name is onReadyStateChange property. So the ReadyState property holds the status of the XML HTTP request object. So what is the status of the XML HTTP request object? So we can get the status by using this ReadyState property. So the onReadyStateChange property defines a function to be executed when the ReadyState changes. So you can call it as an event. So every time the ReadyState property changes, this event triggers, that is onReadyStateChange event triggers, and this function is executed. So the status property and the status text property holds the status of the XML HTTP request object. So now we can just print the status inside this function. I will be just seeing you in the next slide. So this is the ready state. So I have told you in the earlier slide that is ready state holds the status of the XML HTTP request that we have requested to the server. So there are some codes you can write, that is 0 signifies that request has not been initialized, 1 signifies that server connection established, 2 is request received, 3 is processing request, and 4 means that request finished and response ready. So now we have to target this 4 property, and status you have seen 200 signifies to OK, 403 forbidden, and 404 page not found. So now in the next slide, we just have to write a simple function, that is xhttp.onReadyStateChange. So when the ReadyState property changes, every time this function executes. So this check for the property, that is this check if the ReadyState is equal to 4 and if the status is equal to 200, then only execute these steps. So I am just manipulating the inner HTML of the ID demo. And I am just initializing the response that is coming back from the server. So we are executing this anonymous function when this ready state change event trigger or ready state value becomes 4 and 200. So step number 4. So in the step number 4, we just have to send the request by using the send function. So just xhttp.send. So now just we have to write this line of code in order to send the request. So this is how we send the request to the server. So this line is very necessary. So wrapping it up, showing you the complete example. So let me show you. So complete AJAX example. So let me show you the complete code. First of all, we initialize the object and store it in the XHTTP variable. And whenever the ready state property is equal to 4 and the status is equal to 200, we are just manipulating the inner HTML of the ID demo. And we are initializing the response that is coming back from the server. And we are opening a connection and we are providing a get method. We are providing a URL, that is ajaxinfo.txt, and we are providing a boolean true variable which signifies that this is an AJAX request. And lastly, we are sending the request to the server by using this send method. So these four steps we have discussed in the previous slides. This just showing you the steps. It is number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4. So these four steps are necessary in order to make a AJAX request to the server. So hope you guys, you learned something from this tutorial. I think that I have made some effort to, so thank you guys for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel for more videos like this.